Now, the original problem was a lack of available food to feed a growing German population, with the three alternatives of 1. Increasing productivity of the soil, 2. Internal colonization, and 3. Importing food, all deemed by Hitler as unrealistic solutions, then population increase appears out of reach for Germany, as Hitler wrote himself.
From an examination of all factors, especially in view of the limitation of our own raw materials and the ensuing threatening dependence on other countries, Germany's future perforce appears very gloomy and sad.
So in a situation when the demand for food increases because of a growing population, while on the other hand the supply and amount of food cannot increase because of the above-mentioned reasons, then what happens? While Hitler never exactly explains how he reasoned here, the following seems to be how he got to his conclusions of birth control and emigration. Well, as a simple matter of supply and demand, if the supply of a product such as a food is stable, but the demand increases with time, then the price will go up. It will keep going up as long as the population and demand keeps going up. The food will never run out in such a situation, but rather at some point the food cost will get prohibitively expensive. We have to remember that a family has many different needs and wants. Having children is just one of them among several, like food, housing, education, healthcare, leisure, and more. The essence of economics is to make choices about allocating limited resources to satisfy different unlimited needs and wants. And to think that a family is willing to sacrifice their entire living standard just to have another child is not realistic. In the family's private economy, the overall living standard on the one side would have to be weighed against more food and more children on the other side. If the cost of raising additional children significantly impacts the overall living standard, they may try to solve the situation themselves and decide to have fewer children. Hitler seems to acknowledge this likely situation here.
Through their own measures, they try to bring about a rectification as they understand it and as it arises from their own insight. The fight against having the child begins. They want to lead a life like others and cannot. What is more natural than that? The responsibility is put on large families in which no joy is taken anymore and which are limited as much as possible as a burdensome evil.
When food has become too expensive, the family prioritizes keeping their living standard rather than having another baby. When having another baby is deemed undesirable and out of the question, the solution that people then resort to is not to stop having sex, but rather to 1. Use birth control, or 2. To emigrate. They would use birth control to avoid increasing the number of family members, or they would emigrate to get the family out of Germany into other countries where the economic and food conditions are better, just as he writes.
Then, instead of fighting for daily bread, the nation rather will cut down on this bread and, what is even more probable, limit the number of people either through peaceful emigration or through birth control in order in this way to escape an enormous distress. Emigration and birth control are the medicines recommended for our nation's salvation by the representatives of pacifistic economic policy and the Marxist view of the state. This reduction of the population was sometimes effected through hunger, sometimes through emigration, and at times through endless unfortunate wars. In recent times, it has been effected by voluntary birth control.
But why does Hitler hate birth control, and why does he hate emigration? What is his logical reason against them?
Check out the next part of this documentary below.